put herself in this gold medal, and this will be an exciting one.
It was a 3-1 victory against Ozaki in the semi-final for Tani Bakova. She'd beaten Aimbatova of Uzbekistan in 13 seconds in her first contest, and right from the off, this should be explosive. Tani Bakova in blue of Kyrgyzstan, Purevdujin of Mongolia in the red.
Both of these athletes are seasoned competitors, have wins against some of the biggest names, are the biggest names in this sport.
Four-time Asian champion Tani Bakova, that last title coming in Kazakhstan in Almaty 2 years ago. Finalist last year, of course, but lost to Ozaki when injury struck right at the end.
And Tani Bakova, she's known as being dangerous from every position. She's got incredible body position on all of her attacks, and she wrestles for that full 6 minutes. Today, so far, with the Mongolian wrestler, we've seen her be a little slow to get started, but she's come from behind in two of her matches to win, and definitely a killer on the mats when it matters most.
Yes, this is a wrestler who relishes an upset. Purevdujin, she's done it before against Japanese opposition.
Yes, Purevdujin is one of the few wrestlers, one of the only wrestlers, I believe, who has a win against Kaori Icho, four-time Olympic champion from Japan.
Yeah, she delivered her first loss in 13 years when she beat her in 2016.
Exactly, so she's no stranger to coming up big when it matters most, but she does have an extremely worthy opponent in Tani Bakova, and already we see the Mongolian on the activity clock. And this is an amazing display of hand fighting as we see them trading blows, looking for inside control. Trying to get those angles, trying to come into pressure. And so on that initial attack, we see the Mongolian with a great deep waist putting Tani Bakova to her back, but Tani Bakova responds, comes back on top and gives her a chance to the turn. So on the tie, because Mongolia has a 2-point takedown, she's leading on the tie, and Tani Bakova has 2-1s. So on the criteria, she's not winning.
That ability from both wrestlers to counter each other after an attack on display there, and with 10 seconds to go in the first period, it set things up very nicely for the next 3 minutes. Not much to choose between these two at this stage, is there?
No, but Asulu Tani Bakova does have the weight of a nation on her shoulders. She is, you know, one of the biggest celebrities from Kyrgyzstan, and she faces a lot of challenge in her home country as she's so widely recognized. And there we see Nurbek Isipakov, the coach of Kyrgyzstan, and he's built this program from small villages across that country into the powerhouse of wrestling that we see today. We see the athletes wiping the sweat from their bodies, you know, trying to maintain a dry surface so we can get a lot of exciting ties and action over the next 3 minutes. And wrestling is a sport of respect. We always see them shake hands at the beginning of every round.
Kyrgyzstan missed out last night when Aypiri Medetkirza went for gold in 76 kilograms. Can Tani Bakova deliver the gold?
We're seeing her back in this high crotch position, and Mongolia is once again trying to defend, trying to knock her off the takedown. Tani Bakova comes up on top. And she gains control. She goes for that gut wrench and she's trying to come through. She gets her elbow caught and she gets put to her back. It's back in the ties. It's a dangerous position for Tanya Bykova. She's able to scramble and gain control. What a battle.
Just can't take your eyes off it. And the referees having to pay such close attention to award these points as move and counter move taking place on the mat.
Exactly. We've seen two offensive attacks by Tanya Bykova, and we've seen two counters by Mongolia. And so this has been a really exciting kind of cat and mouse game.
Tanya Bykova just ahead then.
In Greco-Roman wrestling, we had two gold medal champions, and they were absolutely swarmed by the Kyrgyzstan fans after they won their medals. And so we can hear in the stadium the Kyrgyzstan fans going crazy over the last minute and a half of this match.
And those neutral Kazakhstan fans as well, taking sides as well to get behind either of these two.
So there's a minute and a half left, or just under, and Perdovjin is going to have to come up with something special if she wants to score on Tanya Bykova. And don't take your eyes off it. We have a minute of wrestling, and this is going to be a flurry of action, I think, to end this match.
Low shot from Perdovjin, but she's countered by Tanya Bykova, and here it comes. Just can't get the exposure. Extra point added, two, in fact, for Tanya Bykova.
Exactly, she still has that bottom leg. She's looking for an additional 2 points exposure, and again, she gets it. She's breaking this match open.
Last roll of the dice from Perdovjin, but five behind from this position against this opponent. And it's too difficult a mountain to climb. Aysulu, Tanya Bykova wins a 10th Asian Championships medal. And of course, it's a gold medal. She becomes a five-time Asian champion. 9 points to 5 at 62 kilograms. It is Kyrgyz.